Welcome to the 3C Live Experience, a dynamic, multiracial, fast-growing church with thousands of believers filled with passion for God and for people. Let's join 3C in this live experience.
Greetings, 3C family. Good to have you with us. We're going to get into the Word of God. I know the presence of God is right there where you're at. We've had tremendous ministry. Thank you, Boosie. We've had tremendous worship, 3C Live. And God has already been working within your life, right? And now it's time for the Word just to seal that through the power of the Holy Spirit. And know that this is Communion Sunday. We're going to be partaking of communion. Make sure you've got the elements. Make sure you've got the juice. You've got the bread. And at the end of the message, we're going to partake as a family together. We're going to partake of communion. And welcome to everybody, those that are in the homes, 3C at home, my 3C at home. Good to have you with us. And then, of course, we've opened up quite a few of our venues all over the place, except our main venue, Centurion. We haven't done that. We're still working out the strategy as to what we must do because there's so many people. So we'll let you know about that. But a lot of our other venues, probably about 15, 20 venues, we've already opened. And I know with me there being on the big screen, I know that you've been blessed by the word that is going out already. The presence of God is right there where you are at. Well, we're going to get into the word of God. The title of the message is Great Exchange. That's also the hashtag, a great exchange. Let me great exchange.
Great exchange.
And we're going to be looking at the blood of redemption and our text, 1 Timothy 2:5-6, we're reading from the Message translation, and he says that there is one God and only one, and one priest mediator between God and between us, God and man, and his name is Jesus. What's his name?
Jesus.
Jesus, who offered himself in exchange, the great exchange, in exchange for everyone held captive by sin. Why? So that he could set them free, so that we can receive our freedom. Jesus made the exchange. In other words, he paid the price. The New King James Version says the following: there's one God, one mediator between God and men, the man Christ Jesus. And the Bible says he gave himself as a ransom. He gave himself as an exchange, a payoff, a release payment. He paid the price so that we can be free. Isn't that incredible?
Amen.
And yes, some of us, of course, we don't even know what freedom is. It's only when you meet the Lord Jesus Christ that you truly understand what true freedom is. Now, it's important. As we partake of communion, the Bible teaches us to do that together as a family. Revelation 12 and verse 11 says, and they overcame him, how? By the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony. The Bible says, and they loved not their lives to the death. In actual fact, the New Living Translation says, they were not afraid to die. If you're afraid to die, you'll be afraid to live. If you're afraid to die, you'll be afraid to live. You'll always be intimidated by that spirit of fear, that spirit of timidity that we speak about in the book of Timothy, that spirit of timidity, timid. We get the word intimidation, where we are intimidated in our life, in who we are, in what we're doing. But you know, that's never been God's plan for your life. God wants you to live fearless lives. Amen. 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 God wants you to live a life that is a life of conquest and a life of overcoming. That is God's will for us. But the only way we do that is when we have received Jesus Christ into our life. How did they overcome? By the blood of the Lamb. It's the blood of Jesus, the great exchange, where he exchanged, took on everything on his life so that we can walk in true freedom. Now, the first revelation of redemption we find in the book of Genesis. And that exchange was made in the garden. And it started off with sin, because when Adam and Eve were alive, they had not sinned, but they went and they ate of the tree. You know, they had all the trees to eat, but there was one tree where God said, hey, don't eat of the tree. And what did they do? They ate of that tree. And what happened? They sinned. They rebelled against God. And because of sin, it changed their view of themselves and it changed their view of God. And that's why an exchange took place, where the Father took their clothes and clothed them with His clothes. You see, they were born in the image of God. Man was born in the image of God. But when they defied God, when they sinned and they said, Lord, well, we don't trust your word. We don't trust you. You see, they clothed themselves with themselves. But you see, then the Father came and He came to the garden. He didn't write them off, but He came and He brought salvation.
Amen.
Amen.
You see, so what did they lose when they sinned? And what do you lose when you sin? They lost their God consciousness because suddenly they were consumed with themselves, right? Because they saw themselves, they saw them, they were naked. Up till then, wasn't an issue. But suddenly they became self-conscious and their vision changed. Their vision changed. It shifted from looking at the world from God's perspective to looking at their lowly, lowly perspective. Instead of seeing the world like God sees it, they were seeing the world from their lowly perspectives. It's the difference, like, you know, looking out of an aeroplane and seeing the world, it suddenly looks so small. Or when you're on the ground and you look up, you see everything seems so big. It's two different perspectives. You see, and what we see for the first time ever in life, we see the introduction of fear. Wow. The introduction of guilt. The introduction of condemnation into the world. Then what do we see? We see the self-effort, trying to be right, be a good person, doing the right thing. And then that false sense of pride that goes with it, thinking we have the ability to actually define what it means to be a good person. Self-righteousness, thinking, hey, we did a good job. And then wanting, you know, to subject others now to our righteousness. In other words, now others must be according to what we think is good. No, no, no. You see, when God saw Adam and Eve, He immediately made a plan. He immediately had to deal with, you know, their vision of redemption. And what did He do? The Bible says in Genesis 3 and 21, then God made clothing from animal skins for Adam and his wife. In other words, there was an offering that took place. There was blood that flowed. And we see that He then went and sacrificed an animal. And once again, and He brought the clothes and He clothed them and there was an exchange. He said, give me your lives. Give me your clothes. There was an exchange. Said to me, great exchange.
Great exchange.
And that was pointing towards Jesus. You see, already in Genesis chapter 3, the Bible is pointing towards Jesus that would die on the cross of Calvary. His blood would flow for us to forgive us our sin, to cleanse us so that exchange can take place. And understand this. There is no change without an exchange.
Amen. Amen.
There is no change without an exchange. Say it with me. There is no change,
is no change
without an exchange.
Exchange.
Say it again. There is no change,
is no change
without an exchange.
Exchange.
That's why as Christians, we always celebrate the cross. We always celebrate the blood of Jesus. You see, change comes when you are walking in a continuous revelation of the power of the blood of Jesus. That's why with communion, the Bible said, do it as often as you get together. You see, the cross before me, the cross before me, the world behind me, right? The cross before me, the blood of Jesus, the power of the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus Christ that was shed for us. There's no other way. God wants to pour out His blessing on our lives each and every day. But we've got to understand there's only one doorway to the blessing of God, and that is through the cross, a revelation of the blood of Jesus. And that's why as a church, we never, never, never miss a communion service, right?
Yes.
Proverbs chapter 20 and 18. What does it say there? It says there, where there is no revelation, the people cast off restraint. In the King James Version, it says, where there is no vision, where there's no vision, the people perish. The New Living Translation says, when people do not accept divine guidance, they run wild, the Bible says. I like the Amplified Version. It says, where there is no vision, no redemptive revelation of God. He says, the people perish. In other words, how do you see yourself? And how do you see God? Well, that is determined whether you've had an encounter with Jesus Christ, if you have made that exchange within your life and start seeing the world the way God sees us. Is this helping somebody?
Yes. Yes.
Now, what we're going to do today, I've got a few of our senior leaders in our primary team, and they're going to come share, and we're going to look at the five confessions of redemption. I know that many of you already know this within your life and it's part of your lifestyle, but I want to make sure once again that everybody is operating as far as the blood of Jesus Christ and the confessions, the declarations that we need to speak concerning your life in Christ. I know within my life there was a time that I was really struggling. There's a time within my life, there was a lot of pressure, a lot of stress, and there were things we couldn't conquer. There were things as if, you know, it was as if we were not getting breakthrough. And I had a chat with Pastor Cesar, and he said to me, Bert, well, how do you do devotion? Do you do devotion? I said, yes. He says, how do you do devotion? He says, do you do the five confessions of the blood of redemption? I said, yes, I do that like once a week or so. He says, I do it every day. Every day, every day. Say with me, every day.
Every day.
Every day. From that day, I started confessing it every single day. The five confessions of redemption in our life. And you know what? It's not that my problems went away. And I think God purposely placed me within the midst where I had no control. Say with me, no control.
No control.
You see, you can only give control over to God when you have no control.
Yeah, that's right.
And sometimes within our lives, God brings situations within your life where you have not any control, no control, right? Like through the COVID situation we're going through, right? There's certain things we can control, certain things we can't control. And of course, we always want to make a plan. We want to make a plan, and then our plan makes it worse. And then we got another plan and it makes it worse, and another plan and it makes it worse. But you see, how to learn on a daily basis. How to give the control over to God every day in the midst of the situations, in the midst of the circumstances, in the midst of the pressure I was experiencing where I had no control. And within these situations, when I tried to fix it, I made it worse. And when I tried to fix it, and then I said, that's it. I'm done with Bert's plans. And I say, Lord, I give it over to you. You deal with it. I give it over to you, and whatever it is, if I must lose that, and that doesn't work, or whatever, then so be it. But Lord, my relationship with you is number one. That's what it Amen. Is. I am a child of God, and you know where that comes from? A revelation of the cross of Christ within my life. So we're going to start off with Marius. He's going to come forward, and as he comes forward, after Marius, we've got Zintle. That will be speaking, and after that we'll have Fumani that will be speaking, and I'll take it up straight after that. Thank you, Maurice.
Thank you, Pastor Bert. We overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony, not loving our lives to the death. And we're looking at the first confession today that says, by the blood of Jesus, I am redeemed from the power of the enemy. And it's so important that we have a redemptive revelation of the cross, because unless we know and have a revelation of what the cross is about, we cannot walk in the benefits of the cross. We see that when Adam and Eve in the garden, when they sinned against God, that humanity was thrown into sin and into slavery. And there was no effort from man's side that could reverse that transaction. That transaction had severe consequences, thrown into fear and living without confidence. And we see that no sacrifice of humanity, no price that man could pay was enough to reverse that detrimental transaction that took place. But the word says in the book of Ephesians chapter 1 verse 7, he says, in him we have redemption through his blood.
Amen.
In Christ and in Christ alone. Through his blood and his blood alone. There was no other price that could be paid as a ransom for humanity. Now, the word redeemed means to buy back. It means to be removed from the marketplace. It speaks about the liberation of an object, a possession, or a person, and to lose from slavery. You see, there's a price that is paid for someone to be redeemed. We see that often on television where a family's loved one would be in captivity and there's a ransom required for their release. And unless the price is paid, there would be no exchange and the person would remain in captivity. The Greek word here, to lose, means to lose and to set free. And that's like a person being imprisoned as a result of their inability to pay their debt. Now, in the first place, they are imprisoned because of their own inability to pay the debt. And they would remain in that prison until they have covered their debt, which is an impossible task. There's nothing that we as humans could do to ransom ourselves, to pay the price for ourselves to be set free. Yes. But by the blood of Jesus,
Amen.
We've been redeemed Amen. From the power Amen. Of Amen. The enemy. Now, within the Christian context, the word redeemed speaks about the redemption and being set free from the slavery of sin. Sin was the grip and the hold that the enemy had on our lives. And because of that grip, we were slaves to sin and not free. But we know that whom the Son sets free is free indeed.
Amen.
In the book of Matthew chapter 20, verse 28, the word says that Christ came and he gave his life a ransom for many. Jesus paid the ultimate price with his life to ransom us human beings, the children of God. In Hebrews 2 verse 14, the word says, because God's children are human beings, made of flesh and blood, the Son also became flesh and blood, for only as a human being could he die, and only by dying could he break the power of the devil who had the power of death. Jesus came as a human being, and he paid the ultimate price for our redemption. And in the book of Romans chapter 6, the word says here, we know that our old sinful selves were crucified with Christ, that sin might lose its power in our lives.
Yes.
We are no longer slaves
Amen.
Of sin. Come
Amen.
On, say that with me. I am no longer,
I am no longer
a slave to sin.
A slave to sin.
The power of Satan was broken over our lives by the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
Sin, the very grip and the hold that the enemy had on our lives, was forever demolished by the blood of Jesus. He has lost his power over our lives. The dominion of sin over our lives was removed forever. God, our Father, paid the ultimate price. John 3 verse 16, for God so loved the world that he gave and he sent his only begotten Son, so that whoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life.
Amen.
There was an exchange that took place. God the Father sent Jesus to take our place, to die our death that we might be redeemed and have everlasting life. John 3 verse 16 is just what I quoted. You can be free today because of the price that Jesus paid through the blood of Jesus Christ. You no longer have to walk in guilt and shame because Jesus carried your guilt. He took your shame upon his life to the cross. And by faith in the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, you have been redeemed from the power of the enemy.
Amen.
Come on, just where you are. Don't you want to make this declaration boldly and clearly with me today. Say with me, by the blood of Jesus,
by the blood of Jesus,
I am redeemed,
I am redeemed
from the power of the enemy.
I have been rescued
from the dominion of darkness and brought into the kingdom of Jesus,
the Son of God.
By the blood of Jesus,
I am redeemed
from the power of the enemy. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.
Awesome. Thank you for that, Pastor Marius. What a powerful word. We are redeemed because of the blood of Jesus. And thank you so much to Pastor Bert and Pastor Shanae and what you mean to my wife, Thokozile, and I. The second confession of the blood of redemption has to do with forgiveness. The Bible teaches us, and this is the confession, by the blood of Jesus, I am forgiven of all my sin. Won't you say that with me? Say, by the blood of Jesus,
by the blood of Jesus,
I am forgiven of all my sin. Say it again. Say,
by the blood of Jesus,
I am forgiven of all my sin. And the Bible teaches us, as Pastor Marius has quoted earlier, Ephesians chapter 1 and verse 7, the second part, it first says, in him we have redemption through his blood. And then it says, the forgiveness of sins. God has called us into this place and we have the forgiveness through the blood of Jesus. Isn't that just great news? Yeah. That there is a pardoning. There is a pardoning for our wrongdoings. We don't have to walk around with the heaviness of guilt and the heaviness of the consequences of our actions, but we can be forgiven because of the blood of Jesus. Yeah. So Jesus paid. He paid with the stripes that were on his back. And because of that blood, that means that we have forgiveness of sins, meaning a restoration of our hearts. See, Jesus restores our hearts. The forgiveness of sin is not only for our hearts, but then there's also a healing of our sicknesses, which is a healing of our bodies. So forgiveness of sins, which deals with our hearts, and then a healing of our sicknesses, which means that we can also have complete deliverance from every sickness and disease known to man. Yes, amen. Even COVID-19, and we've seen countless amounts of people being restored back to complete healing because of the blood of Jesus. I'm encouraged by Psalm 103 and verse 3. The Bible says, it's speaking about God, and it says, who forgives all your iniquities, yes, who heals your diseases. Yes. Jeremiah 31 verse 34 says, for I will forgive their iniquity and I will remember their sin no more.
Amen.
God
Amen.
Will not hold your sin against you. He will remember it no more. That's just how God forgives. And we too, if we are to receive that forgiveness, we need to be able to forgive in the same way that God forgives us. He remembers it no more. So you might ask yourself the question, so how do we get to that place? I see many of you right now, I'm sure you are anxious and you're saying, hey, I want to be forgiven of my sins. Here's how we get there. The Bible teaches us in 1 John 1 verse 9, it says, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us and to cleanse us of all unrighteousness. Amen. To receive forgiveness, we gotta start by acknowledging that we are sinners. We've gotta acknowledge where we are wrong. We've gotta acknowledge, not the self-righteousness that Pastor Bert was talking about, if I sinned. Not if I sinned, we are sinners. And we've gotta acknowledge that before the Lord. God can only deal with us if we are transparent, if we fess up where we mess up, if we own up to our wrongs as our own. Which means we've got to check what is the motive of our hearts. What is inside our hearts? Are we living for ourselves or are we really living for the cause of God? That fight that you had with that family member, was it your own agenda or your own heart that was coming through or what was the issue there? We've got to make sure that we acknowledge our sins before the Lord. I love what Psalm 139 says. This is David in that desperate place. He says, search me. Search me, O God, and know my heart. God needs to search us, and we've got to come to Him with that understanding that it is only Him that can bring us the breakthrough. Search us. Search our hearts, Lord. Have I been selfish? Have I been living for myself? Have I been mistreating those who are around me? Search me. And verse 24 says, and see if there's any wickedness in me. I like what the Passion Translation says. It says, see if there's any path of pain I am walking on. The question today is, are you walking on a path of pain because of the unforgiveness that you are holding? The pain. And I want to let you know today that it is time to let go. Hallelujah. Amen. If we confess our sins, He is faithful. He is just to forgive our sins. And personally, I've experienced walking on this path of pain. When I was much younger, I was 6 years old, I think, my parents got divorced and our father left. And that crushed me. As a young person, it crushed me. I was offended, and I carried that unforgiveness and that resentment to my earthly father for 11 years. 11 years I walked with the path of pain because I did not let go. It was only, and I love this series on the Great Exchange, it was only when I went to the Encounter Weekend and I had an encounter with the cross. Come on, somebody. Yeah. You know that when you have an encounter with the cross of Jesus, your life will never be the same.
Amen.
And it's amazing that when I encountered the cross, I didn't encounter my father's sins. But the Lord showed me the sin that was in my life. The sin that put Jesus on the cross. And I had to first get to that place where I realized I need God. God is faithful. God is just. Faithful meaning what? God wants to forgive you. He has the heart to forgive you. He sent Jesus as a sacrifice, as the ransom, as Pastor Marius was sharing, for you and I. The Bible also says He is just, meaning what? He has the legal right to forgive. But what stops God from extending that grace to us? It's the measure that we use to forgive. And this is why it's important that whatever stops us from receiving that forgiveness of others, we've got to make sure that we deal with it. Matthew chapter 6 and verse 12, the Lord's Prayer, Jesus teaches us, and we pray this, even in schools we pray this, and you might have grown up praying this. And it says, forgive us our sins as we forgive those who have sinned against us. Further down the line, verse 14 to 15, it says, for if you forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses. Understand this today, 3C family. We cannot afford not to forgive. We cannot afford to continue walking the path of pain. We cannot afford to die with unforgiveness within our hearts. Our sins have been forgiven. And here's the greatest part. After releasing my father at the Encounter Weekend, God, I was able to receive the forgiveness of God. Unfortunately enough, that my father is still alive. So God also managed to bring healing of that relationship. And here's another illustration. Our pastors have always taught us, and I'm going to close with this. They've always taught us that the natural principles are also the same or similar to the spiritual principles. It's about 17 years ago, I was fighting with one of my siblings, and I got pushed off the couch, and there was a broken glass, and I've got a scar here. And the broken glass cut me real deep, and it was extremely painful. So painful that I needed to go into the hospital. I needed to get a stitch. And whenever someone touched it, oof, it was painful. But 17 years later, I still have the scar that reminds me of what had happened 17 years ago. But when I go there, I don't feel pain. And in the same way, when we receive forgiveness from the Lord, it's not that we're just going to forget everything. We're not computers or robots. You can go there. Or when someone goes there, there will not be pain. Why? Because God will completely restore your heart. Instead, you will be able to use that test as a testimony and be able to bring freedom through other people's lives. Revelation 12, 11. And they overcame Him by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony. Now when someone goes there with my Father and I can freely speak about it. There is no pain. Why? Because I have been forgiven and God has healed me in the name of Jesus. Come on, let's make this declaration one more time. Say with me, by the blood of Jesus,
by the blood of Jesus,
I have been forgiven.
Of all my sins.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Fumani.
Thank you, Pastor Bert. We love and appreciate you. And I'm going to be speaking about the third confession of the blood today. And the third confession says this, that the blood of Jesus cleanses us now and continually of all sin. Amen. Amen. And we get this out of 1 John 1 verse 7. We walk in the light as God is in the light. We have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus, his son, cleanses us from all sin. Amen. What an incredible promise that is. That not only have, as we've learned, that we are forgiven of our sins, but also we are cleansed. We are purified from the inside out. Amen. Amen. As we walk in constant relationship with God and with people, God continuously, a constant process of purification with inside of us. And you know, we all need this. None of us are perfect. And we live in a world that is evil. And what the enemy tries to do is he tries to take sin, to taint us, to get us to the place where we start believing the lie, where we start being discouraged, where we start being hopeless, where we start believing that we are not good enough, we don't have it, we don't have it within us, it is impossible. But you see, that's the lie. Why? Because God, the blood of Jesus, is continually working within us. Yes, I remember. I remember a couple of years ago, we were praying together and Pastor Bert shared this message. And as he shared this message, he said something really specific that touched my life at a point where I needed God to come and move within my life. And he said this as he preached this word. He said, God is not done with you yet. Amen. Amen. God is not done with you yet. Let me tell you, God is not done with you. God is not done with your family. God is not done with your marriage. God is not done with your children. Amen. The blood of Jesus is at work within your life. Amen. And therefore, we have peace with God. You see, peace with God, now we can move in the plan and the purpose of God. Amen. Amen. And none of us are perfect. None of us have it all together. And that's why we need the blood. In fact, the Bible says in the next verse, in verse 8, it says that if we say that we have no sin, then we actually deceive ourselves, which means that we lie to ourselves and the word of God, the truth is not within us. So we can boldly come to God and say, Lord, I'm not perfect. I need your cleansing, which is not just now, but it is continuous within my life. But now, being fallible, not being perfect, how do we walk in the light? And he says it in the next verse. He says in verse 9, he says, if we confess, you see, there's two words you need to remember today, transparency and honesty. You see, if we confess our sins, God is just. He is faithful and just to forgive us of all our sins and to cleanse us of all unrighteousness. Amen. Isn't that incredible?
Yes.
It is two fruits that we get out of being open and honest before God. God forgives us, but also he cleanses us continually. Therefore, we can be just like David in Psalm 51, and we can come before God and say, Lord, have mercy on me. Have mercy on me, openly knowing that we come to the Father. And you know what? Just like, how do we then confess? How do we then get to that place where we can walk in the light? What we need to do is just like David did in verse 2 of Psalm 51. He says, wash me thoroughly from my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. The first thing we need to do is we need to desire it. We need to desire the cleansing. That sometimes it's not easy. Sometimes the washing and the purifying is not, doesn't always feel good. But let me tell you, we need to desire it just like David desired. We need to say, Lord, come and wash me clean. Cleanse me today. And then what does he do in the next verse? He says, now, for I acknowledge my transgressions. We need to acknowledge that we have transgressed against God. But thank God for the blood of Jesus that forgives us and cleanses us now and continually. Listen to me. God is not done with us yet. Amen? Amen. Come on, won't you just confess this with me as we confess this word? And we're going to, I want to encourage you to continue to confess it every single day, like Pastor Bert has said. And let's confess it. And let's confess with me. Because I walk in the light and have fellowship with other Christians, the blood of Jesus cleanses me now and continually from all sin. Amen. God bless you.
Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. That was powerful. Thank you for Marnie. Thank you, Zintle. Thank you, Marius. And yes, once again, that's part of our primary team. Men and their wives, men and women that are on fire for Jesus. And thank you for that powerful word. By the blood of Jesus, we are redeemed. By the blood of Jesus, we are forgiven. By the blood of Jesus, we are cleansed now continually from all our sin. And then the fourth one is, by the blood of Jesus, we are justified. And God sees us just as if I had never sinned. Say with me, by the blood of Jesus, I am justified. Come and say it with me. By the blood of Jesus, I am justified. And God sees me as though I have never sinned. So we're justified by the blood of Jesus. And that's a legal state of being. Free from accusation, free from guilt, and free from condemnation. And the devil will come and try place guilt on your life and try place condemnation, say, you're not good enough, you're not going to make it. But that's why we have Jesus. We know we're not good enough. We know we don't have what it takes. That's why we need Jesus. And justification means that when God sees you, he sees you as righteous. Why? Because the blood covers your sin. The blood covers the wrongs. The blood of Jesus covers our sin. Isn't that incredible?
Yes.
Isn't that powerful?
Yes.
And that brings us to the last one. By the blood of Jesus, I am sanctified. Sanctified means set apart for God's purpose. I am sanctified and set apart for God's purpose. Say it with me. By the blood of Jesus, I am sanctified and set apart for God's purpose. And that's what we looked at last week, didn't we? We spoke about this sanctifying the family, sanctifying our neighborhood, sanctifying our nation. In other words, we're living for purpose, in purpose, on purpose. Why? Because of God. You cannot live a life for purpose, in purpose, on purpose, apart from walking with the one that created you and knows exactly how you function, how you are. You think you know yourself. You understand? God knows you better than you know yourself.
Amen.
And anything you try to do out of yourself, trying to make yourself better, trying to make yourself holy, just distorts the original image of God for your life. So what do you need? You need God within your life. And that's why, as I was sharing earlier, you know, when you come to that realization, that's the foundation of everything that I am. By the blood of Jesus, I am redeemed. In other words, I am redeemed from the power of the enemy, taken out of the kingdom of darkness. Now I'm in the kingdom of his love. I am forgiven of all my sin. By the blood of Jesus, I am cleansed now and continually. So God is busy working and moving within me. I am being cleansed. I am being washed like with a scrubbing brush. Some of us is a stall bottle, you know, a steel brush some of us need, right? But through the power of the Holy Spirit, we've been cleansed. God is working within us, in us. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Come and tap your neighbor and say, God's not finished with me yet. Don't worry. Tell your neighbor, I'm getting there. Say, neighbor, have patience with me. We've been cleansed on a daily basis. But as we are being cleansed, we're justified. In other words, the position that we have is one of righteousness. You don't have to try be righteous. You are declared righteous. It's a gift from God. It's by grace. It's not by your works. And at the same time, know that you are sanctified, that you are set apart for the purpose of God. There's a reason you are alive.
Yes. Yes.
You see, when you understand that revelation of the cross, now you can live life without fear, not afraid to die. And there is no ways you can lose because God is in control. God has got purpose. In the midst of what you're going through, it's a stepping stone for what God wants to do in and through your life. Whatever you've experienced makes you stronger to achieve that which God wants you to be. Amen?
Amen.
But then the foundation has to be the blood of Jesus. And therefore, I want to pray with you before we partake of communion. And I wonder if every person, just bow your heads, every head bowed, every eye closed. It starts off by giving your life to Jesus. And maybe you have not received him into your life. You see, calling yourself Christian doesn't make you Christian. Writing Christian on your census form doesn't make you Christian. Going to church doesn't make you Christian. You need to be a child of God. That's why it says, unless a man is born again. Born again, meaning what? Born of God, to become a child of God. You're born of your parents, you know, the first time, to have the right to be human, but to be a child of God, you're born of God. And what happens is when you give your life to Jesus and saying, Lord, I'm a sinner, I need you in my life, God comes and he does a supernatural work on the inside of your heart, taking out the old nature, the Bible says, and placing his nature within you. You see, out of yourself, you can't change. You can modify your behavior to a certain degree, but you can't change your nature. You can't change who you are. You see, but God can change you. God can transform your life. If you invite him into your life, if you believe and invite him into your life, God will change you. And therefore, I want to give you that opportunity while nobody's looking around, every eye closed, every head bowed. I'm going to count to three. And if that's you, I want you to raise your hand and say, yes, Lord. And I'm going to do a prayer with you. If you want to receive Jesus Christ, then maybe you're backslidden. Maybe you've done this before, but you've moved away from God, but you know you need God. You want to come back to the Lord. If that's you, I want to include you in that prayer. And I want you to raise your hand as well. So if you want to receive Jesus Christ in your life, quickly raise your hand. One, two, three. Yes, Lord. I'm going to ask one more time. Just one more time. Because I don't want you to miss out on this. Sometimes we think, okay, you know, you're looking at yourself. God is speaking to you, you know, but I can do this at a later date. No, no, no. You've got no guarantee you'll be alive tomorrow. That's a fact. You've got no guarantee of it tomorrow. God is speaking to you now. You know that's God speaking to you. That voice on the inside, must I do it, mustn't tell it, that's the voice of God. Please don't reject the grace of God in your life today. I'm going to ask one more time. If you want to receive Jesus Christ, quickly raise your hand. One, two, three. Yes, Lord. Now I want to pray with you. And I want everybody to pray that no one's embarrassed. Say with me, dear Lord, I need you in my life. I am a sinner. Today I give you my life. Everything that I am, I surrender unto you. My whole life, I give to you. I trust you, Lord. I trust your word. It says, if I receive you and believe, I have the right to be called the child of God. Thank you, Lord. As from now, I am your child. I belong to you. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. You now belong to Jesus. Isn't that exciting? Amen. You're a child of God. Now you need to grow. You need to grow in the Lord. Important to get into training. Please send us your details. We want to help you. We want to help you develop your life and grow. There's a live link. Just go to that link on our live streaming and just fill out the details. Or go to our website, my3c.tv, and just go to the commit button. Just press this button that says commit. Go to that button. Send us your details. And we're going to give you a call and make sure that we can help you develop and grow in the Lord. Now we're going to partake of communion. And I wonder if everybody can stand just there we are as you become aware of the presence of God. And if you've received Jesus Christ into your life, you now have the right to partake of communion. If you're not a child of God, please don't partake of communion, because the Bible says you partake a curse over yourself. So please don't partake of communion if you haven't received Jesus Christ into your life. But as a child of God, we're going to partake of communion as the family of God. And the Bible said, do this as often as you get together. The night that Jesus was betrayed, he took the bread and said, take, eat. This is my body that was broken for you. And you see, his body was broken so that we can receive redemption, forgiveness, that we can be cleansed, justified and sanctified. That's why Jesus died on the cross of Christ, on the cross of Calvary, to absorb all our wrongs, absorb all our sins. But the Bible does say, as Zintler said, is that we need to forgive others before God forgives us. And while every head is bowed, every eye is closed, if you have issues with other people and unforgiveness, just there where you are, I want you to forgive them in the name of Jesus. Just say there, Lord, I release them. I forgive them right now in Jesus' name. God will not forgive you if you do not forgive others. And also, if you want healing in your heart, God won't heal you unless you forgive others. The step of faith is you releasing and forgiving others. Just there we are. Just release them. Just forgive them right now in the name of Jesus. Release right now in the name of Jesus. And now God can forgive you. Say with me, Heavenly Father, I've forgiven those who have sinned against me. I pray that you'll forgive me all my sins and trespasses in Jesus' name. Let's partake of the bread together. Then we have the juice that represents the new covenant in his blood. The new covenant that we have. In other words, the ability that we have to walk in victory in every area of our life. That's where we have the seven places where Jesus shed blood. Every one of those places speaks about the victory we have in every area of your life. God wants to bless you in your health, bless you in your finances. God wants to bless you, you know, in your ministry. God wants to heal your heart. We have a new covenant through the blood of Jesus Christ. And say with me, Heavenly Father, thank you that you are in control of my life. Everything I need is provided for. A new covenant through your blood. Let's partake together. And I thank you, Lord, that as a church together, you bind us in a bond of love. By this shall all men know that we're your disciples, is the love that we have for one another. Thank you, Lord, that through your blood we are united, we knitted together, that we lay down our lives, live for one another, be a blessing to those that are around us. And you give us the capacity to be able to do that through the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for your grace. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your love, Lord. We love and appreciate you. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Church, are you blessed?
Yes.
Are you blessed? Hallelujah. We are knitted together through the love of our Lord Jesus Christ. Now, remember what's happening this week. Women's conference. Amen. Ladies, are you ready?
Oh, yes.
Can I hear the ladies?
Oh, yes.
Whoop, whoop. Right. Ladies, are you all ready? Great conference. And that is on Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, right? From 7 to 9 o'clock live on TBN, 7 to 9. And then, of course, it's also live on a YouTube channel as well. So make sure, ladies, that you're connected. If you're not yet registered, make sure that you are registered. Go to the website, make sure that you are registered. And I'm not sure if there's spaces in the building. Remember, we can do 250. So we've got a whole bunch of venues where we'll be coming together. And if you want to get connected, you're welcome to do that if you want to join in. But it will be live on TBN Africa, 7 o'clock Tuesday, 7 o'clock Wednesday, 7 o'clock on Thursday, the Women's Conference Braver. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Well, church, I'm going to pray over you and release you. See you in the week, and we're going to return together next Sunday. Just raise your hands as I pray over you. Lord, I pray a blessing over each and every person. Thank you, Lord, that we could have come together, received of your word, knowing that we're forgiven, that we are redeemed, knowing, Lord, that we are cleansed, knowing, Lord, that we are justified, that we are sanctified through the blood of Jesus. And Lord, whatever is needed, Lord, you provide the resources that are needed, the wisdom that is needed, the health that is needed, the peace that surpasses all understanding, that will guard each and every heart and mind through Christ Jesus, and that the joy of the Lord will be your strength. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Amen. Church, we love you. God bless you.
See, God has come to save me. I will trust in Him and not be afraid. The Lord God is my strength and my song. He has given me the victory. 3C Church presents the annual It's a Girl Thing Women's Conference, Braver. Live on TBN Africa from the 28th to the 30th of September 2021. Hosted by Pastor Shane Pretorius. Featuring international guest speakers, First Lady Trina Jenkins and Pastor Geraldine Balano. With guest artists Mariah Smallbone, Doro Zombambo, and CC Winans. Online registrations are now open on my3c.tv.
Oh, sibonile izolo umuhle empilweni zethu siyakubona namhlanje umuhle empilweni zethu siyakubona ukuthi uzoba umuhle nakusasa empilweni zethu uthembekile ufanele udumo akekho njengawe ufanelwe ungigcwele unamandla we thank you now For the last time, say,
you make me strong so I won't fall from the hand of the enemy. You've delivered me. I am not alone. You make me strong so I won't fall.
3C Live Experience was brought to you by the 3C Media Production. For more information, call us on 086-111-2345 or log on to my3c.tv.